Okay, I don't know if anybody's here yet. So I'm gonna wait a minute. Got our supervisor in the background over there. What you doing, buddy? Okay. So this is just going to be a quick little video. Excuse me. I had a hot knife made by Weller for probably 22 years, and it wouldn't warm up, and that's the only time it failed me. So I went and got a new one. This is a lot different than the kit that I had. But this is a wood burning kit. It comes with all kinds of points for various things. Wood burning, model cars, doing lead work, stained glass, that sort of thing. It shows all kinds of examples on the box. For those of you that don't like to buy tools or don't think you need another tool, this is the tool to get. So you can use it as a soldering iron, you can use it for a hot knife. And I've got the X-Acto blade in there, and as you can see, a brand new knife. It's already turning purple. That thing is hot. I can feel the heat off of it from here. So this was $18. Comes in a nice storage box. And I was going to buy this one and hopefully change out the points, but I don't know if that point will unscrew and accept the knife or not. Regardless, I have a $170 instant soldering gun, but I can always use a backup soldering iron somewhere, so I'll probably attempt that one of these days. But what I liked about this one is it has a LED ring on it, and it was 60 watts. This is a 25 watt and supposed to be higher temperature. I don't know how that's possible. With a 60 watt and 880, I don't know whose math is what, but anyway. So we'll be testing this out one of these days. So, anyway, I grabbed some China samples just to show you the variation of going through these sprues. The idea is to take these parts off of the sprues, off of the supports. We're not going to finish getting them ready for paint tonight. The point is removing them from the sheet. We're gonna do another bow crane just to show you how delicate an X-Acto knife can be. Again, all we're gonna do is just separate it from the supports. So let's get this out of here. We've had a few people break the chains, forgive the pun, and I'm going to show you how to cut out the chains to where you don't break them. I'll even take on the hatch number one, and we'll cut away the walls and stuff on the deck bits one. So again, we're not going to do any model finishing tonight. It's all to show proof that it works. So these are the original cranes and bases. I'll take a couple of these off. I'm not going to do the whole sheet tonight. I just want to prove a point, or the right tool for the right job. So let's get this set up. So this has been warming up for probably 22 minutes. If you don't trust yourself with a sprue cutter, look at that. It just goes right through that. You're not trying to force it. You're taking your time. Watch your fingers too. This isn't about a race. And no, I'm not forcing it. I'm just letting the knife sit on top of it. This resin doesn't melt, it just cracks apart when you apply heat. And I'm trying to get as close to the lifeboat as possible. Now you can go down here and cut away all of this. In fact, if it were me and I had to do this over again, I would start down here just to see how hot it gets. Make sure you're not going to accidentally melt something you don't want to melt. And it would also serve the purpose of taking stress off of the part. Just got to remember, it's not a race. Ouch, that gets hot. Okay, we need to stop for a second and put the blade back in. That gets hot. I didn't expect the blade to come out. I did even tighten it down with pliers. So I will be right back, and I'm going to get some different pliers. All right, tighten these back down. All right, let's see if I can burn my thumb again. That smarted. It is. Now, you're going to have to go in here and sand all of this anyway, even if you would have used sprue cutters. But there it is. It's not broken, and it's cut off. So, let's do a crane base. Now the idea here is to just release it from the supports. Just take your time. Ouch. And don't poke yourself either. Okay, there's that. There's a lot of supports to cut through, and this really makes the difference. As long as you don't burn yourself and poke yourself. So let's take off. And somebody can come back in here and clean all of this up. Now, that little ridge right there has to stay in because you've got the holes here. Keep that in mind. So stay about halfway away from the part and the bottom. All you want to do is just stress relief this part. That's all you got to do. not again. Just got to keep working at it, guys. Go. It's a lot of things to cut through, but now you can get at it and clean it up. Just remember, stay away from the part as much as possible, but just cut through what you need to cut through. You can always clean it up later, but if you mess up now, you're gonna wish you hadn't. Oh, here, we gotta do the front. See how easy that goes through there? I'm not even pushing that hard. I'm just holding the knife on it. There it is. Well, almost. Where am I stuck? Go. Cutting through all of those supports, you got to have a hot knife. That's hatch number one. Now you can go through and clean all that up. Personally, I wouldn't clean out the inside. I would just go in here. I would go in here and snip out all of these. That's all I would do. There you go. So, on the deck chains, you have to take the ends off first. So, what you want to do is you want to get in here without touching that part. And you're going to achieve that by going this way. Yep, no. Just that easy. Want to see it again? Like I described in the other video, you can feel these pieces pop. And all you're doing is stress relieving the parts. Okay, now we're going to go with the knife. These are a little bit more delicate. We're going to start in one section, move to another section, move to another section, move to another section. To keep it from popping apart, you're also going to hold your finger on it. You don't need to hold it tight. You just need to keep the stress level to a minimum. In fact, it'd probably be a smart idea to cut this in half, which I'm just going to do right now. And all I'm doing is laying the knife on there. As soon as it starts going through, move it. Move it. Now it just popped. See how easy that is? So, what you want to do, instead of working from one end to the next, you want to take this slow. I'm going to start here at the front. I'm going to stay away from the part as much as possible. Then come down here. Then move up a little bit. And find another spot. I'm not pushing all that hard, but pieces like this, when you get a lot of supports in there, they're kind of a pain in the butt. Now that I got this half loose, I don't want to be pushing on it too much. Let's see, how do I get back in here? That is a little valve. You need to save that. There you go. It's a lot of supports, but you get the nice deck chain with it. And don't forget your valve. All right. So this resin, the gray resin, should be really easy to cut through. that one. Now be careful cutting down through here, because we're right on top of some of these parts. Just like that. Okay. So we got lifeboats, a deck chain. Let's see what we can do with the bow. Oh, and we got the crane bases and the cranes. Okay, I think we're loose there. I can't say this enough, guys. This is not a race. There it is. Well, that's one of them anyway. still stuck on here somewhere. Oh, that. Here it is. Okay. Well, I got to get up in a few hours, so I'm going to call it a night. But you can also use a hot knife on these. See the bottoms? You can use a hot knife and go in here and slice these off one at a time. I would do it upside down in a bowl, but that's just me. Just remember, let the tool do the work. It's that easy, guys. No snapping, popping, flying across the room. Get yourself a hot knife. For those of you overseas that don't have Weller and you want one, let me know. I'll pick one up for you. Plus PayPal fees. Okay? You guys have a good night.